In this video, we'll see how to format the output of your traceroute that has been saved in the file trace.txt. So you'll notice on my screen that I've already run the traceroute command, and I've redirected it into a file. So I have the file trace.txt existing, and I can verify that by taking a directory, looking at the contents. And of course, that's a Windows command. You would use ls. If you're in a terminal window on Unix or on a Mac. And I see that the trace file exists. And now what we need to do is we need to get that into Microsoft Word and get that nicely formatted. So notice for my particular situation, I was working on a home computer. I've created a folder to store this file. So I'm in C users, Jon Bek documents, CIS-101 network assignment is the name of my folder. And that's where I'll find trace text. And it's handy to keep make a note of that so that you know where you're going to look for it with Microsoft Word. And so let's go ahead and start Word. And you can just pick that from your pick list on the desktop or however you usually start Word. I like to just start it by calling WinWord. And now I'm going to open an existing document and we'll browse over. So if you're working on a computer in one of the campus labs, you might have it on the S drive. On your personal computer, it might be on your C drive, C users, whatever your default user is, wherever you stored that. And remember, in my case, I put it specifically in a folder called under documents, and I called that, let's see, what did I call that? Let me take a quick look. I called it CIS-101 network assignment. So CIS-101 network assignment. Now notice initially under Word, because that was a text file, it's not yet a Word document, I'm not seeing it because my filter in Word by default is looking only for Word document types. Let me switch that over to all files. And there's trace.txt, and I'm going to open it. Now I've got my raw file, and I'm ready to begin editing it, but let me help you avoid a gotcha that will trip you up. If you just save this file after you've done your formatting, and just say save, it's going to save it back as just a plain text file, which is going to lose all your nice table formatting, and that's very sad because that's going to cost you points. So let's cancel that. And let's start right away and do file save as, and I'm going to put it right in the same directory, but I'm even going to call it trace, the same thing, but instead of trace.txt, I'm going to change it to a document file format. Great. So now I've saved a new file called trace.docx, and now any formatting I do is going to be preserved. So let's take a refresher on how do we convert the content we want into a table in Microsoft Word. So the first thing I'd like to do, I have some text up here above the information I want in the table, and I have some text down here below the information I want in the table. Let me go ahead and delete that. So I just highlighted it and deleted it. And I come down to the bottom, do the same thing, highlight it, hit the delete key. And now let's highlight the text that I would like to convert into a table. And if I go up to the ribbon and choose Insert in Microsoft Word, and I would like to turn that into a table, and let's convert text to table. And by default, it's going to break each row at the physical end of line, and that's just fine. Excuse me. All right, so now we have a table with one big column in it. We'd really like to have that as three columns. So let's select that table, right click on it, and insert a column to the right. And Control Y, we'll do that a second time. So now I have two columns. And I'd also like to have a heading for it. So I'm going to highlight that first row, right click in it, and come in here and say insert above. And now I have my heading. And if I were to go back to my instructions, it will tell me what the heading for that should be. So let's take a moment and do that. All right, so I brought up the instructions, and here is a sample of the table layout in the instructions. And let's see, that first column is supposed to be trace information. I'm just going to copy that right out of that instruction sheet and come back over and paste it in here. And I'm going to change my view a little bit. I'm more comfortable working in the print layout. There we go. That looks a little bit more like the printed page. And now let's go back over and grab that sample. The second one is supposed to say IP class. And then that third one is supposed to say owner or private. And there it is. And I'm going to go ahead and save that at this point. And so now I'm ready to continue with the remaining steps, where I will analyze the IP addresses and put their class in here, A, B, or C. And then over here, I should either have the word private, or having done a lookup on an internet registry, find out who the IP address belongs to. So over here, let's grab a public one. This is a public address way down here. I can look that up on the internet registry, and I would put the owning organization name into the owner column. All right, hope that is helpful to you, and we'll see you next time.